Well, students, our today's topic is National Adult Education Program. And the objectives of the lecture are, number one, understanding adult education as a crucial component of nation-building process. Number two, understanding the factors responsible for launching of National Adult Education Program in India. And number three, to know the outcomes of National Adult Education Program in India. Literacy rate of India in 1947 was only 14%, and the female literacy was abysmally low at 8%. Only one child out of three had an opportunity for enrollment in primary schools. This poor educational scenario led to economic inequality, gender discrimination, and rigid social stratification. Thus, eradication of illiteracy became one of the major concerns for the government of India. Need for universal education for all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years was recognized as a crucial input for nation building and was given due consideration in the Constitution. The Constitution of India directs the state to make provisions for securing the right of children to education within limits of economic capacity, and to provide compulsory education to all children up to the age of 14 years by 1960. It also lays down that the state shall promote with special care the educational and economic interests of the weaker sections of the people. In light of the constitutional directives, Education Commission was appointed in 1964 up to 66, which recommends that high priority be accorded to liquidation of illiteracy and urged that adult education should be promoted through selective as well as mass approach. The Education Commission also stated that in the world of science and technology, main objective of the education should be to relate it to the life, needs and aspirations of the people so as to make it an instrument for socio-economic and political change. The first nationwide attempt at eradication of illiteracy was made through the National Adult Education Program 1978 to follow up the recommendations of the Education Commission report and subsequent National Policy on Education 1968 of Government of India. A massive program of adult education called National Adult Education Program for removal of illiteracy in the 15 to 35 age group was formulated by the Government of India and launched on 2nd October 1978. The target for this program was to educate 100 million adults within the time frame of 5 years. The objectives of the National Adult Education Program were not merely to impart literacy in the conventional sense, but also to provide learners with functionality and awareness, which were conceived as three integral components of the program. Literacy meant acquisition of skill of reading, writing, and numeracy. Functionality implied the ability to utilize and apply the skills so acquired in day-to-day life. Awareness aimed at knowing, understanding, and taking action on issues which affect the individual, community, and society so as to improve their quality of life. Now, let's come to why adult education. All learning is change, and all education aims at producing it within the learner as a person and in his or her behavior. Education, since it aims at producing more competent, better informed, more understanding people, has implied within its goals the possibility that its activities will indirectly cause change in the society. Our Indian society before independence in 1947 and after it up to 60s witnessed a very slow pace in achieving this change because a major chunk of population was not able to participate in the transformation process due to lack of adequate knowledge and paucity of skill in this regard. Here the skill is referred to as basic literacy or proficiency in reading, writing, and numeracy. Important transformation, however, had been taking place elsewhere in the world. The changes in the economic philosophy of the world had affected various sectors of activity. Among other things, the average level of education had risen and there was new scientific knowledge to deal with. The international market had become more competitive, and at the same time, the economy had become dependent upon imports and exports. This resulted in the necessity for a concerted effort in production. We know that highly industrialized nations attached substantial value to the basic and advanced training of skilled workers in every field and at every level, both in technical sciences as well as in the agricultural organization. It is generally recognized that to an ever-increasing degree, prosperity and quality of life depend on knowledge and proficiency in skills. Many of its initiatives have had the explicit goal not merely of producing people capable of achieving change, but people who will achieve it, and moreover, in a particular direction. An adult, in fact, is already possessing knowledge about their contemporary social order, their local specific issues, their family needs and requirements, etc. It is argued that their knowledge can be expanded and enriched when they are capable of having more information and interaction with day-to-day happenings on economic, political, and social fronts. Dear students, let's now discuss the relationship between education, literacy, and social development. We need to have a conceptual understanding of education, literacy, and social development and their interrelationship so that we understand the factors which made the Government of India to take adult education as essential for human development. Education has doubtless an important functional or utilitarian dimension. This much is revealed when one asks questions as, what is the purpose of education? The answer too often are, to acquire qualifications for employment or upward mobility, wider opportunities in terms of income, and also to meet the needs for trained manpower in diverse fields for national development. But in the deepest sense, education is not instrumentalist. It's not to be justified outside of itself because it leads to the acquisition of certain psychological and social attributes. Education then is a process of expansion, conversion, not in the sense of converting or turning students into doctors, engineers, etc., but the widening and turning out of mind, the creation, sustenance, development of self-critical awareness and independence of thought. In other words, education is not a preparation for life, but finding a way of life. The concept of finding of a way of life carries two important implications. Number one, it implies that every adult, regardless of literacy levels, is already in some way educated, since merely to survive is necessarily to find some way to live. Number two, it implies that there can always be an expansion and enriching of knowledge and sharpening of learning capacities, because education is a process of finding and not a find. Dear students, let's now focus on literacy and its relationship to education. Literacy is a form of training for enhancing individual capacities and confidence to enrich one's education and creative energy. Literacy is not a guarantee that one will become more educated, but it certainly provides the potential for such enhancement so as to function more effectively in a fast-changing world. Literacy is an empowering skill which reduces many fears of being lost, cheated, or manipulated by others. It increases access to many types of information that an individual needs to achieve more satisfying life, to carry out responsibilities more effectively, and also to participate in socio-political activities with confidence. Relationship between literacy and social development. Socio-economic development has both an individual and a collective or social dimension, as It is a problem not for an individual only, but for the society as a whole. Literacy, therefore, in some cases may mean greater or better opportunities for socio-economic improvement in individual lives. Mass poverty cannot be resolved by treating it as a sum of individual problems to be resolved individually. Individuals together make a society. Therefore, the problem needs to be seen as a collective problem requiring collective solutions. Now, let's come to the main topic, that is National Adult Education Program. In a society like ours, human resource was yet to grow and was far from contributing to the overall development process. And therefore, a concerted effort to harness the human resources was needed in order to compete with the international development strategies. Hence, a well-organized adult education program became a priority for Government of India. The long history of adult education, or what is better termed as adult literacy, in India has witnessed important changes in government and public perceptions. Though included as an ingredient of community development in the 1950s, the government's responsibility for it was soon abandoned. Instead, it became an issue of humanitarian welfare to be carried by private welfare organizations, occasionally aided by grants from Central Social Welfare Board. In the 60s, however, functional literacy began to be emphasized by UNESCO, and some responsibility of the government had to be admitted. It was only in late 70s that the Government of India undertook the enunciation and implementation of official adult education program as essential for human and child development. The strategy adopted under National Adult Education Program was mainly center-based, where 20 to 30 adult learners were enrolled in each center. Under National Adult Education Program, rural functional literacy projects were sanctioned by the central government, and the erstwhile 144 farmers' functional literacy projects and 60 non-formal education projects were merged into it. Further projects were added, and the number of projects throughout the country in 1987 were 513. In each project, there were 300 adult education centers. An appraisal of National Adult Education Program 1978, as seen through the monitoring reports of Adult Education New Delhi, indicates that a total of 44.22 million learners were enrolled in adult education centers in different years up to March 1988, as against the target of 100 million. No figures are available as how many out of these successfully completed the literacy program, but on the basis of sample evaluation, it was estimated that 45% of the enrolled learners would have attained literacy. Thus, the level of achievement of this program in relation to the target set for it was only 20%, which is considered to be very low. Center-based scheme under National Adult Education Program had been reviewed and evaluated by several institutes of social science research and other agencies between 1978 and 1985. Their findings, as summarized in the National Literacy Mission document, revealed many strengths and weaknesses. The strengths, as per the National Literacy Mission document, were: number one, women's motivation and participation had been high. Number two, coverage of weaker sections of the society was higher than the target. Number three, the project approach to management adopted for adult education program was feasible. Number four, the quality of teaching learning material prepared by National Resource Center and State Resource Centers were found to be good. Number five, the program worked well where special recruitment procedures were adopted. In spite of these strengths, the program could not produce the desired results and also did not meet the target in the specific time period. The reason for this dismal performance of the program was based on the weaknesses, as per the National Literacy Mission document, on various counts like: number one, poor training of the functionaries. Number two, poor learning environment in the adult education centers. Number three, no appreciable support by the media. Number four, gap between voluntary agencies and the state governments. Number five, no linkage between basic literacy, post-literacy, follow-up and continuing education, resulting in the relapse of large number of neo-literates into illiteracy. Number six, achievement levels of literacy were below the desired level. And number seven, lack of political and administrative support and Panchayat Raj institutions. The National Policy of Education 1986, as amended in 1992, and the plan of action thereunder lays stress on following a dual-track approach, emphasizing both on primary education, non-formal and adult education programs. National Literacy Mission, which was set up in 1988, took over the National Adult Education Program as it was conceptualized in 1978. The National Adult Education Program followed the center-based approach under the Rural Functional Literacy Projects. The center-based approach consisted of one Rural Functional Literacy Project of 300, 200 or 100 centers, and almost each district had one project sanctioned to it. Each center, run by one paid instructor at the rate of rupees 100 per month, was to cater to 30 learners. Launching of National Literacy Mission in 1988 led to a review of all the ongoing programs at that time between 1978 to 1985. The program was evaluated by a number of professional evaluating agencies, which pointed out major ills of the program, like the community was not involved in the program. In fact, the entire implementation mechanism was centralized, hierarchical, and bureaucratic. B, political and administrative support of the state government was not forthcoming in adequate manner. C, learner motivation and participation was irregular, which resulted in dropout and relapse into illiteracy. Considering these deficiencies, a change in strategy was felt, and the entire adult education program had to be shifted to a mission model, which showed remarkable progress in literacy scenario in the country. To conclude, National Adult Education Program was a beginning towards a fully literate Indian society, though with many weaknesses. Thank you. Thank you very much.